Enjoy your listening. Tatiana Danina. The Teaching of Jekyll, Esoteric Natural Science. New Esoteric Astrology. Chapter 12. The Proof of Existence of Celestial Bodies. Progenitors, the Central Celestial Body of the Universe, CCBU, the Nuclei of Supergalaxy and Galaxy. We have no plans to persuade skeptics that vehemently denies the existence of astrological influences and do not recognize astrology as a part of human knowledge. We do not hope to on instant revolution in astronomy. We only wish to interest in the new concepts those open-minded researchers in astronomy and astrology who are not fully satisfied with the whole set of information and facts available to these two sciences. At present, the theory that asserts the idea of existence of the central body of the universe and of the phased birth of all other celestial bodies of a smaller scale has not yet gained popularity and worldwide distribution. However, sooner or later it will happen. And people everywhere will know the true history of the formation and existence of our universe. We want to give to your attention the number of facts that can help to take the new knowledge to those of you who are already internally ready for it, who is configured to the same information wave that we are, and who would not deny that catches your eye just because it is at odds with conventional notions system. We appeal primarily to the independent from the public opinion seekers of truth. We hope for them. Here are the promised evidences indirectly supporting our concept of the structure of the world. First, it is in the constellation Virgo there are the largest clusters of galaxies. In the upper right area of this constellation, at least 2,500 distant galaxies is concentrated. This cloud of galaxies goes beyond the boundaries of Virgo and extends into the region of the constellation Coma Berenices. It is believed that it is located at a distance of not less than 1.3 billion light years. The local supercluster of galaxies, Virgo Supercluster, is the system of galaxies with a size about 200 million light years, including the local group of galaxies, the cluster of galaxies in Virgo and several other clusters and groups of galaxies. In total, the local supercluster includes 100 groups and clusters of galaxies, with a dominant Virgo cluster in center, and about 30,000 galaxies. Its mass is of 1,015 solar masses, 1,046 kilograms. It, the local cluster, is a flattened form, consisting of several chains of galaxies, filaments, whose projection on the sky looks like a band covering the whole sky, within which there are most bright galaxies, a kind of analog of the Milky Way. This feature in the distribution of the night sky objects was discovered the first time by the great astronomer William Herschel in the late 18th century. Then it was rediscovered several times, until finally, in 1953, it attracted the attention of Gerard de Vaucouleurs, USA. The words about the fact that the local cluster, as it is called in science, in projection on the sky looks like a band covering the whole sky, within which there are most bright galaxies, are and all prophetic and absolutely accurate. This fact of existence of the Virgo supercluster of galaxies can be seen as indirect evidence that the central celestial body of the universe is projected exactly on this constellation. Other superclusters of galaxies in the sky like this do not exist. And, besides, where in this part of the sky come from so many galaxies? In our view, the theory of random formation of celestial bodies from the gas dust matter is somewhat naive. And the conception of ejection of smaller amounts of material from the larger, as a result of heating the latter, looks more convincing. This was the first proof of our theory. Second, according to our hypotheses, as well as to the basics of esoteric astrology, the nucleus of supergalaxy is projected onto the constellation Taurus. It refers to the element Earth. A presence in the constellation of two very large star clusters, the Pleiades and Hyades, can serve as a proof of this fact. Two large star clusters are projected on one constellation. Again, coincidence? And, maybe, it's immediate confirmation of our proposed model of the universe? Third, The law of gravity was discovered by Sir Isaac Newton in the 17th century. However, scientists still do not yet fully understand its mechanism of action, and can't always recognize its manifestation in the nature. This was said to draw your attention to two undisputed, in our opinion, evidences of existence of the giant celestial bodies progenitors, and the phenomenon of gravity serves just as evidence to this. As you know, our planet is closest to the Sun in early January, when the Sun is projected onto the constellation of Sagittarius, 147 million km. Once upon a time when astrology was only born, at this time the Sun projected on the Capricorn. While the Sun is projected onto Sagittarius, Earth is closest to the opposite sector of the sky, the constellation Gemini. At the same time, the Earth is farthest from the Sun at the beginning of July when our star is projected onto the constellation Gemini, 152 million km. And the planet itself at this time passes through that portion of the orbit that is closest to the constellation Sagittarius. About what do these facts evidence? They are just explained by the law of gravity. In the first case, when the Earth is closest to the Sun there is a weakening of the attraction. In the second case, when our planet is farthest from the Sun, there is a strengthening of gravity. But what does pull the Earth when it moves around the Sun's orbit? We hope you guessed it. The shape of the orbit of the Earth, as well as of many other planets, has a peculiar form, elliptical. Moreover, the Sun is not in the center of the ellipse and is biased to one of the foci. Scientists assure all that this form of orbit explained by the Kepler's laws. However, Kepler only indicated on this fact, but did not explain it. We, on our part, offer as an explanation, the action of gravity of the giant celestial bodies, which include our planet and our solar system as small components. Three huge celestial bodies cause our system: the central celestial body, the nucleus of supergalaxy and the nucleus of our galaxy. Naturally, they have the fields of attraction. And the force of gravity of them affects on any celestial body in our solar system. It is this force alters the shape of the orbits of the planets, forcing to deviate from the ideal circular motion. According to the law of gravity, the greater is the mass of the attracting body is, and the smaller is the distance, the greater is the force of attraction. The central body is the largest and the most massive object in our universe. However, the distance between it and our system is very large, billions of light years. Hence, the smallest gravity force felt from its side, namely the distance, plays a major role. The nucleus of the galaxy, on the contrary, is the smallest in size and mass. But it is the closest to us. And therefore the force of attraction is very tangible. Gravity of the nucleus of supergalaxy is intermediate in size, as well as its size and the distance to it. It turns out that the central celestial body attracts, affect with gravity, planets least of all. So, its weakest attraction least of all alters the shape of the orbits. It weakly rejects them to itself. And on a sector of the element air this is most noticeable. After all, it is the element air indicates the greatest distance. So, it becomes clear why the planet closest to the Sun in January, when it passes through the sign Gemini, relating to the element air. The planet is closer because it deviates slightly by gravity of the central body. We remind you that part of the sky belongs to the Gemini constellation, experiencing the influence of the central body of the universe, it is projected onto the Virgin. At the same time, the nucleus of the galaxy attracts heavenly bodies of our solar system to the greatest extent. And because this it most strongly alters the shape of the orbits of the planets. The nucleus of the galaxy is projected now on the constellation Sagittarius, once upon a time it was projected on the Capricorn. That is why, when the planets are on this section of the sky, they are in the most distant from the Sun. The Sun itself at this time is projected on Gemini, and there is the beginning of July on the calendar. The constellation Sagittarius now refers to the element Earth, the biggest part of it, which indicates the shortest distance to the galactic nucleus. We hope that presented evidences partially or completely have convinced you in the truth of our theories.